In today's lesson, you'll be both an engineer and a fermentation scientist, trying to figure out how to create an environment where you will make yeast as happy as possible. What do you already know about yeast? You see, yeast are living organisms, fungus to be specific, and they can be used as tiny factories for us humans to make chemicals or molecules of interest. As yeast go about their daily business of taking in nutrients and excreting wastes, us humans have learned how to take full advantage of these biological processes. You see, yeast undergo fermentation. That is, they take in sugars as food, use that sugar as an energy source, and then excrete liquid ethanol and gaseous carbon dioxide. You can think of rising bread or making of wine or beer. For centuries, humans have exploited fermentation processes. The CO2 gas can make that bread rise, and the ethanol is what makes the alcohol in beer or wine. That ethanol can also be used as a fuel source. In the US, most of our light-duty cars and trucks run on a blend of 10% ethanol and 90% petroleum fuel. Yeast produce lots of valuable molecules that scientists are interested in. For example, the company Novozymes uses yeasts and other microorganisms to grow up specific enzymes that they recover and sell in various industries. Yeast can grow in the wild, but they are also grown in controlled environments, in labs, or biomanufacturing facilities. The containers where the yeast are grown are called bioreactors. This is where the yeast are growing and metabolizing, but bioreactors come in different sizes. And this is important when you think about biomanufacturing. If you want to optimize or perfect the growing conditions of your yeast, you'd want to start small. That way you can test a bunch of different conditions at one time. And when I say different conditions, what do you think of? Remember, these are living organisms. What might they need to survive and to thrive? It could be the type of food, the temperature, the pH, the gas concentrations, the amount of mixing, etc. All of these things exist in the environment. All of these things could affect how happy your yeast are. So, what would you want to test out? Which combinations at a small scale? We call this smallest scale a lab scale or bench scale. And here's where you can finally control the conditions and not use a ton of resources in your testing. Once you've fine-tuned the yeast growing conditions, what would you do next? Would you go to a production scale, where we're talking about thousands of gallons or hundreds of thousands of gallons in giant tanks? If the conditions didn't work, that would be a lot of wasted material and a lot of unhappy or dead yeast. For this reason, most biomanufacturers have an intermediate scale called pilot scale. And this is where they grow the yeast to resemble conditions close to those of production. In our lab activity, you'll be designing a lab scale bioreactor. You'll have a set of materials to use, and you'll be given a yeast suspension and sugar source. You'll need to design the system so that you can quantify or measure how happy your yeast are. Someone should be able to use your bioreactor today under certain conditions, and then tomorrow under those same conditions and find the same result. Now it's your turn. Consider the materials available and design a system where you can grow and quantify yeast fermentation. Later on, you'll build and test your design and then use the bioreactor to conduct an optimization experiment.